Hi everyone, this is Brendan here and welcome to my next episode, day 39 of my Let's Clash series. So I've been farming really a lot for the past few days, especially for this particular episode itself. So I did have a lot of a high loot rate, so I've decided to show you guys those kind of really higher loot rates, such as above 280,000 gold rate. I won't be showing those kind of 220,000 gold rate as compared to like last time, as now there's really a lot of replays, there's a lot of attacks I've been doing that has above 300,000 gold available, as now the loot is really totally insane. Like this particular one, as you can see, has almost 400,000 gold available. So going to attack for it, especially when the gold, they are all inside the gold mine, is kind of like a dead base, because this guy hasn't been online for quite a while and it's almost the end of the season. So it's just around 3 or 4 more days till the end of the season, and this guy hasn't had a leak at all. So as now you can see, I've stole like half of the amount already and now left with 205,000. So going ahead to steal more of the gold from that gold mine on the left side, and the right side, there's actually 2 gold mines over there. So I have to focus on the right side because there are actually more gold mines over there, and of course I drop my troops to try to get them to go for it. Dropping a rage spell, and of course they're going to fly in, especially my minions going to take out the 2 gold mines really quickly. So level 2 minions, they're pretty strong, especially in rage mode, although my rage is only level 1, but it increases their damage by 130%. So it's really nice to have that damage increment, but of course the speed increment is also really important, because the way they fly will actually change, especially when they fly faster towards the building, and then some defenses won't be able to take them out, especially for those ground troops such as your archers. So like if you actually rage your archers up and they are actually running away, the mortar might even miss them and they won't get damage from the mortar and even not be taken out from them. As if they were to stop and they were to take a few shots on the building and the mortar were to take a hit on them, obviously they will actually go down. But if they were to run while being in a rage mode, they won't get taken out. Sometimes also, it depends on the luck and also the direction that they're actually walking to. So now going ahead, this next attack. This attack is very interesting because as you can see, the gold mines and also the elixir collectors, they're all exposed. So I just have to drop one archer on each of the collectors and also one archer on that DE drill on the bottom over there. And then just wait it out as to just wait for time to just pass. I'm not going to use and spend and waste all my troops. So just gonna wait out my archers to try to take out the gold mine. So just we're gonna slow things down, as now you can see they're just gonna go down one by one. So in 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then the last gold mine over there, it didn't go down because it was a higher level gold mine over there. So now as you can see, they all went down in just a very synchronized manner. So that was really nice. Just left with the dark elixir drill because the dark elixir drill's HP is actually higher. As now you can see, I've used like so few troops, like 13 archers, to get that particular huge amount of loot. And then I'm going ahead to find this 310,000 gold base to actually attack with almost 500,000 elixir, which actually I'm not really too bothersome about elixir right now. But once I reach to Town Hall 9, when I'm able to use my elixir to upgrade walls, I have to focus on both resources, getting both gold and elixir, as I'll certainly require both resources to actually do my upgrades. That's one upgrade, such as my army camp, such as my barracks, such as my research lab, and also my spell factory to get the jump spell, which will be unlocked at Town Hall 9. So jump spell is really fun to use, especially for farming. Last time when I was farming my main account, I didn't use a jump spell, but after they changed the jump spell to make it even better than last time, whereas last time the jump spell, although the radius is bigger, but it do not kind of attract your troops towards the area whereby your jump spell is placed. So after Supercell changed how the jump spell actually works, it actually works pretty well. So I did try farming using some jump spell last time, and it really works really well, especially when you want to direct your troops to a certain area whereby you want them to go to. So when I push all the way to Crystal Lake and I find those kind of storages raid, and then I have to get my troops to a specific area to where I want them to go to, I will have to use a jump spell, follow maybe by a rage spell. So it's going to be a jump spell and a rage spell in that mode. They're going to do a huge amount of damage and they won't be stopped by the wall. So the mortar are going to have a hard time to try to take out my troops. And now I'm going ahead to watch one of the defensive replay that occurred on my base. This guy was using only one dragon to actually attack my base. He was revenging me, and of course I think he was just going to take my tower to get some trophies. So now as you can see, he has used the dragon, and now the dragon has just taken out my tower, going all the way in. flying in to try to lure out my clan castle. My clan castle came out 2 witches, and the witches are going to be taken out by the dragon. Dragon do be able to withstand the damage from the witches, and of course, with such low level defenses, the dragon didn't get taken out until my air defense start to take it out, which was only level 1. But yeah, the dragon managed to do 14% on my base, just only one dragon. And now going ahead to take a look at another defensive replay that occurred on my base. This attack was a more prominent attack. So now as you can see, he's using some archers, goblins, and also some giants. As now you can see, he's going ahead to attack from the very bottom and deploying some archers, and he's definitely going to take out my town hall with the help of the archers going ahead. Town hall has already gone down, and now he has buzzed his way through the base. Skeletons following up behind to try to take out some of his troops, but it's not going to work because the skeletons damage ain't too high. And of course, with only level 1 skeleton traps, the skeletons ain't too many to actually do a huge amount of damage. And now as you can see, the giants, they are just taking out a lot of the defenses, just left with some of the other miscellaneous troops for him to buildings to actually take out. And now going ahead, as now you can see, the giants, they are just going ahead to plummet through the base and scoring him 97%, not even going to get the 3 stars. So now going back to my base, my building has actually completed, my barrier has finished its upgrade. And now I have a free builder, so of course I'm going to do some wall upgrades. So I'm going to upgrade my walls with the 6 million gold I have, used 4.5 million right now. Going to upgrade 2 more walls, and now you can see I have 500,000 gold left. I'm going to remove a tree. While removing the tree, I'm going to search for a raid. So it takes a while to search for a raid, and also some of you have still been wondering whether this method of searching for a raid, as in removing an obstacle and search for a raid, does it exactly help to improve the raid? I would say no, it doesn't. What I'm actually exactly doing is because I do not want to waste the builder time, so I'm just taking this time to actually go ahead to search for a raid. So whenever I can't search for a raid, I'll try to go back and try to remove another obstacle or do another upgrade. So it actually saves times that one, but of course it only saves like a few seconds, but it's better than nothing, to be honest. So now as you can see, the search isn't too where I've been doing a few nicks and nothing actually appears. So I do not want the nicks too fast, so that you guys can actually see exactly what kind of bases are appearing in Golic. And of course, it does take a while for a decent base to appear. So now there ain't any base for me to actually go ahead to attack. I'm going to go back to my base and remove another obstacle and go ahead and do another search. So if this 70,000 gold available base, I'm not going to go ahead to attack. So I'm searching for bases with a decent amount of gold. Not going to bother about the elixir, so just going to focus on the top left. So now as you can see, there's 180,000 gold available on this base, and it's kind of a dead base because this guy hasn't been attacking. And of course, the gold, they are all inside the gold mines, and just focusing my troops on the gold mines or on the bottom. So the gold mines, they are kind of not exactly together, so it's kind of a difficult base to actually go ahead to attack. But of course, with the troops being spread out nicely, there's actually a way to actually take out all the gold mines. So now as you can see, I've taken out like a couple of the gold mines, just left with a few more to actually snatch from him. So just taken out all the gold mine, and now he's just left with 137 gold in the base. I'm just going to go ahead back to my base if I've gotten the amount of loot that I actually got want to get. So I actually do want to get 50,000 gold so that I can have another few more extra gold to actually do some searches when I go ahead to upgrade another wall right now. So I've spent 500,000 on that wall, so I still have a few more 100,000 gold. So I'm going to go ahead to upgrade a few more walls, as I would just want to get my gold to as low as possible, and of course not to as low until I'm unable to do any more searches. So now I'm going ahead to decide to what I'm going to upgrade, as I do not want to screw things up as to use up all my gold and after that I have to do another raid and then waste the builder's time. So now as you can see, I have 26,000 gold left, and yeah, I think that's more than enough to do this upgrade. Now of course I'll be left with a 14,000 gold to actually do another raid. So going ahead to find this 300,000 gold base, of course I'm just going to go ahead to attack it because I do not have enough gold left, and of course this base is a very nice base to find too. So it really does take a while to actually search for bases. It's not as if I'm finding bases in like 1 or 2 minutes or in just a 5 or 6 searches. As you can see just now, I did show you guys that I did roughly almost 20 searches, then I found 180,000 gold rate. But of course, the bonus actually do compensate for it. And of course, I know some of you guys have been saying that you guys are able to find like 300,000 gold bases at a silver link or even in bronze link in just a couple of searches. But to be honest, you do have to add in also the bonus loot that you actually get. So if I were to farm in Crystal League, I actually do get 35,000 gold whenever I win the raid. But I'm not in Crystal League right now, but I'll be pushing my way to Crystal League so that I'll be able to farm over there soon once I reach to Town Hall 9. So that 35,000, if you think that is not a lot, I mean, do consider this. If you look at my profile later at the end of the video, I have like almost or even more than 800 over attack wands already in this season. So if you times like 35,000 by 800 attack wands, you can just imagine how much that will actually add up to. That's like around 20 over million, like 27 over million or whatsoever. So you just imagine the extra 27 million gold that actually contributes to whatever thing that I'm actually able to use it for. It's not too much, but of course it's also still a small amount that actually do adds up. So in 2 weeks getting an extra 27 million, it really does help. But of course I didn't get that 27 million for this round because I was actually farming in Gold League most of the time. But as mentioned, once I reach to Tahona, I'll be farming in Crystal League so that I'll be able to enjoy the bonus too. So if, for example, I'm actually doing 500 attack wands, I think the amount is just pretty decent enough to actually farm for an extra few million for that particular season. So now going ahead, as you can see, I've taken down this base with 308,000 in my hand and taken down the Town Hall 2 with 70%, 75% done. And then I found this Town Hall 8. This Town Hall 8 is quite interesting. As you can see, this base, the gold mines, they are very, very, very full. What I mean by very, very full is later at the end, once I'm done with the raid, you can see that I've stolen exactly 450,000 gold. This is the maximum amount of loot you can actually steal from the gold mines from a Town Hall 8. So that is very high already, I mean, for that particular level of the gold mine. So it's very, very high, especially when I do have to just use only a few of my troops to just take out the gold mine and not have to break my way all the way into the base to even try to take out the storages. So now I'm going to show you guys a few more searches that I'm actually doing. So now as you can see, I've been searching quite a while in Gold League. And of course, it do takes a while, and of course, bases do appear for me to actually snipe. But I do not want to snipe any Town Halls right now to not actually waste time. Because that's actually one of the methods as to me, and that's what I use to actually maintain my trophies. So now as you can see, I didn't find anything. So just going to slowly nix my way so that you guys can take a look at what kind of bases are actually appearing here in Gold League. But do take into consideration one thing, which is I'm actually a Tower 8. So with the new matchmaking system that Supercell has made, which is you actually find the same Tower Hall level as you more often, I do find more Tower 8s more often, and also Tower 7 and Tower 9s. So it's a plus 1 and minus 1 from your Tower Hall level. So I just found this 254,000 gold available base. Going to attack it, definitely. It's a Town Hall 8 and it's a dead base, so just gonna go ahead and attack the gold mines. Gold mines, you can see they're all very full, so my troops are just gonna be focused onto the gold mines. And I'm left with so many troops. As you can see, I have like 20 barbarians left, 39 archers, and even 14 minions left. So I didn't use all my troops, so I managed to still even get 25% with all that loot stolen. And now going back to my base with 3.2 million gold already stocked up. I didn't manage to stock up my gold to the max capacity as I was quite busy. And then after that, now going ahead to upgrade the walls, going ahead to upgrade another level of my elixir storage. So I'm just getting my capacity up again, and as now you can see, I've gotten 167 level 8 walls done. So I still have like around 30% of the walls to try to get them to level 8, but not to worry, I'll still be working on them. Hopefully be able to get most of them to level 8 before I reach to Town Hall 9. And of course I do have to stock up gold for Town Hall 9 too. And of course now as you can see, my profile, my attack wands is at 748, barely reaching 800. So as mentioned, if all those had contributed into the bonus loot, just imagine how much that will actually add up to. So now as you can see, my elixir escape is just 7 million more till I'm actually completing the third star. So we are going to get it definitely in just another 2 or 3 more episodes and get more gems out from it. As now you can see, I'm just going to continue to actually farm for the gold and then just proceed on to 200 million gold grab. So yeah, that's it for this particular episode update that I'd like to show you guys. Hope you guys have enjoyed it. So if that's it, I'd like to thank you guys for watching my video, and clash on.